everyone.
Buongiorno!
Thank you for coming to see a grand feat that has never been attempted before. We will present for you a full three-act Commedia dell'arte at SCA 50-year celebration. I mean, there's never been a three-act Commedia at SCA 50-year celebration before. This is the first time. Wow, this is not as amazing as I thought. It's like this has only been, we've only been here for a week. But this is the grand premiere of a play written explicitly. It is a play all about 50. Whether it be the 50th celebration, whatever that will be, whether it will be 50 ladies wooed, or 50 lords who tried to court. There may be other 50 things that happen. There will be probably at least 50 times that you will laugh. But with much further ado, we, the players from various Commedia dell'arte troops across the known world, present for you the 50th suitor!
Yeah.
No one has seen that kind of magic.
thing happened.
Yeah. The thing happened. Uh-huh. And you'd better be prepared for it. And our girl's going to be married.
Yes.
You hear me?
Yes.
Angelone?
Our daughter will be married by the time of the celebration.
Better be.
What 50th celebration is that crazy woman talking about?
Oh, dear. Hello, my old friend. So good to see you. Yes, yes, yes. We know each other from our university days.
I remember. You look well.
Oh, and so do you. Quite prosperous as always.
Oh, yes, yes.
Yes.
Always prosperous.
Do you remember the days when we put the goat and the professor's drawer?
That was the most action drawers I've ever got.
Oh, you got that right. Hey, I bet you don't remember our secret society handshake.
Of course I do. How could I forget?
I don't think you do. I challenge you.
Huh.
Put down that stick, old man, and show me. Yes, we are not as young as we once were.
Yep.
Are you sure you want to do this?
I'm okay. All right,
here we go.
One, two, three, four.
Ontir, Kai, Atlantia, East, West, Calentir, Aldemir, North Shield, Trimeris,
We forgot Danville, Mark.
Oh, nobody remembers those people.
Well, my old friend, once you come upright again.
There we go.
Tell me more about your life. Tell me about your beautiful family. What's going on?
My beautiful family is in shambles.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
My doctor has gone through 49 surgeries. Can't decide who she wants to marry. This one's too skinny, this one's too fat, this one's too rich. I don't know. This one doesn't have enough knowledge in shoes. This guy here is wearing the wrong shoes.
She's a particular young maiden.
Particular, she's a picky young maiden. And on top of that, Laura keeps talking about this 50th celebration. I don't know what she's talking about.
50th celebration of what?
Yes. I don't know. It's what I'm trying to figure out. She mad because I don't know.
You never know what's going on. You're always But I think I can help you with my big, giant brain.
You have always had a big, giant brain.
I have, and I know of several celebrations that are going on. Yes, there's a celebration of the 50 people in a society where they give their heart and soul for service. And those people are known as the Great Turkeys.
Well, there's no one around here like that. Every single time I hear somebody yelling, we need volunteers in all areas.
Then there are the people who devote themselves to the arts and sciences and have great learning. And they are known by a wreath of poison ivy on their heads.
I think I've seen them before. They're often looking around like this.
Yeah, they do a lot of stretches. And then there are our knights, who give great feats of strength and courage upon the field. They are known by a white noose around the neck.
Probably because they hate themselves a lot.
Yes, it could be that. Or it could be a celebration of the people who are masters with rapier, and they are called the masters of offense. Could it be that?
I don't believe it's any of those. None of those sound familiar. None of them King Gloria is talking about. What am I to do, Dr. A?
All right, I have another idea.
Oh, okay.
Why don't you ask that sexy maid of yours, your wife's maid, Columbina? Yes, the honeypot. I've had my eye on her for quite a while. I'm sure your wife confides in her. Ask Columbina what your wife is talking about. That's how you find out.
Oh, that actually is not a bad idea.
All right.
Columbina, there you are.
What is it, Pantone? Can't you see I'm in the middle of getting ready for all the celebrations? There are no
help finding a suitor for my daughter. And this list is not important compared to my problems.
Isabella, she's been through 49 suitors. Can't you give her a break?
A break? That girl has never given me a break, and you're not given a break either.
You can say that again.
Act like I work you that hard.
I don't know what to do. I care about Isabella so much. She's been through all these crazy men. Oh, and now she needs another suitor. I just really don't know what to do.
Oh, Columbina.
Dottore!
My little honey pot.
Oh, leave me alone! I have a lot to do! And even with you, it's not on my list! What am I to do? I care about her so much. Isabella.
These suitors are a disaster. All I want is romance. And Father keeps pushing the most ridiculous men on me.
Well, Isabella, I know you've been through 49 suitors, but maybe some of them weren't too bad.
None of them were good enough.
I mean, there was the dance master who knew so much and was light on his feet. And he could argue whether the dance moves were in play for one or play for two. And there was the fighter who would talk endlessly about his latest kill. And then there was the poet who always came up with a new, boring poem to Greensleeves. But, maybe the next suitor will be a pirate. Or, there are worse things. Maybe he'll be a Commedia actor.
Not an actor!
Oh, I know! It's Father, so tragic.
Father would never arrange such a marriage for me.
But I must let you know that I just talked to Pantalone, and he said that you will be marrying the 50th suitor.
No matter what?
No matter what?
No matter who it is?
No matter who it is?
Whatever random actor could stumble in off the street and be my 50th suitor and I would have to wed him.
Right, or that know-it-all guy who takes charge of everything but never lifts a finger. It could be anyone. There's so many people out there.
How could my father do this to me?
But wait. Yeah. I think I can get you out of this mess.
Do you have a plan?
Yes, come with me.
Okay.
Olivino, I have a plan. Now that we have arrived, this beautiful city of Venus.
Yeah, we could just walk in any gate. There is nobody there at all.
That's a shame. All the gates were just empty. Although it's hard to find your way around the town. There's no sight. We almost walked right into the canals.
Yeah.
But now that we are here, we have come to the beautiful city of Venus. The filthy gold of Capitano, Moco Blanco, Fettuccino, El Grande, Testosterone. For I have come to this town to find the 50th woman to woo.
Woo!
For you see, I, Capitano, have already found 49 other women that I have wooed.
Yeah, like that Sir Fern lady. She always wrote down fun facts.
Oh, I remember her from a long time ago. It was about the start of the 50.
Yeah, and then there was that lady, Atlantia.
Oh, the fair lady, Atlantia. Atlantia. I really like Atlantia.
Yeah, and then there was that lady on Sophie. She really liked fruit.
Sophie.
Or does she really like colors?
I don't know, but that Sophia. Oh, she was the easiest woman I'd ever wooed. She was just all over the Capitano. I couldn't get enough. It was amazing. But I believe this woman worked so hard and is so amazing that she's not going to be mad at my description of her. We have come here now to find the 50th, the perfect woman to be the 50th woman that the county town woos.
Oh. Ah! Hi. Hello, handsome stranger. Yes,
who are you?
I am Doctora, and who are you?
I'm a man who needs no introduction. So let me introduce myself. I am Captain Donald Mosco Blanco Frappuccino
El Grande
Testosterone. I am the greatest swordsman, the greatest warrior, the greatest soldier, and the most perfect man you will ever set eyes upon.
Oh, I can tell you are a fine figure of a man.
Capitano has a fine figure indeed.
Yes, yes, and my big giant brain has an amazing idea.
Wow.
How I've met you.
You must have a really big head.
I have a giant head and I have big other things too.
Ooh, like shoes?
Yes.
Like peanut butter jars?
Yes, like peanut butter jars. But
ignore the silly watch.
Yes, yes, yes. I have a fantastic idea. My best friend has a beautiful daughter, Isabella.
Beautiful daughter named Isabella?
Yes, a maiden beyond compare. And her father is looking for a suitor.
Oh, I wonder who that could be.
This maiden not only is beautiful, but she's also very picky. She has rejected 49 suitors.
That sounds really familiar.
That's because Capitano has wooed 49 women.
This is a match.
Woo!
This is a match made in heaven. It's perfect.
She is waiting for the perfect man, and Capitano is, of course, the perfect man.
Yes, yes, yes. But do you have qualifications?
Oh, yeah. We got loads.
All the ladies that Capitano has wooed.
This is your documentation?
Yes.
Yeah!
Oh, Capitano remembers all the ladies. Oh, the ladies here. The ladies there. All across the land. Capitano just loves the women.
Pantalone has forgotten why we're having our celebration. And he's ignoring me. And this happens, I hear, at times when you are married for many years. Next line. And I have decided I need to make my husband jealous. How do you make a man jealous? Do you know how to make a man jealous? That's sad. I think I need a man of wisdom and experience who's been around for a while, who might know how to make my husband Pantalone jealous. But do you think maybe one of the most experienced men in the entire SCA would know how to make my husband Pantalone jealous? Do you think? I would be excited to take a class from someone like you in how to make Pantalone jealous. Oh, Phil just came. Here, let's get that one again. Oh, there we go. I'm so sorry my daughter rejected you. She has no taste. Not at all. I'll try and fix it.
I try to live with it.
I'll see what I can do to heal the wounds.
So Pantalone doesn't know when he's got at home. So I'm thinking he needs to be taught a lesson in jealousy, envy, wanting, and maybe an extremely handsome man needs to be brought home with him. Why, hello, stranger.